Saturday, the 14th of January, 2023. Now for something completely different, part four. Favourite fantasies for Cancer and Capricorn. There is a drippy side to every Cancerian, a little bit that still dreams of princes and princesses and the kind of dewy-eyed romanticism that really belongs in Disney. They all want to own a hotel where they can live in the penthouse with a swimming pool. Rarely do Cancerians groan out loud, but if you can get them to do this, either in a sexual or in a culinary way, or better still, a combination of both, you know that you're on a winner by appealing to their senses, primarily touch and taste, but also sight, sound and speech. They love to be stroked, oiled, touched, teased, occasionally fed off of, and generally adored in as many physical ways as feasible at the time. Whilst at the same time, they also occasionally revel in taking the role of worshipper or advocate of their partner, as they are not so self-centered that they neglect others. Whereas Capricorns, on the other hand, are the epitome of extremes as far as self-centeredness goes. They like to be the total centre of attention in the bedroom, being worshipped, adored, stroked, loved and admired to the fullness of potential. Or else they likely to be firmly in the role of worshipper and disciple. They secretly dream of being dominated or dominating. The idea of being all-powerful or powerless appeals to the side of them, but enjoys constraints, whether it's in their clothing or with more personal and secretive ways. Capricorns truly believe that they are the best equipped to set the moral standards for everyone else, and they're astonished when others disagree with their view from upon high. Delusions of grandeur and power normally keep these soft-centered but hard-edged people content, and they act as a buffer to the harshness of the outside and sometimes more real world. There you go, folks, just a little taster. Out on the 18th of January.